Welcome to Bounce Around Charleston. I'm Randolph Miller. Coming up on today's show, weight management is often a chronic struggle that can be very difficult to handle alone, especially for young children and teenagers. MUSC Children's Hospital has a flexible range of services that offers help to individuals who are struggling with abnormal weight gain and are in need of individualized structured assistance to help set and reach heart healthy goals. We will talk with Heart Health Program Manager and Registered Dietitian Janet Carter about some of the services this program has to offer. Now that school is back in session, it is very important that parents pay very close attention to the and identify any learning problem disabilities during early childhood. We'll talk with Mary Beth Dacey, the Executive Director of Life Management Center, about some of the learning and the associated challenges in order to help some families start the school year off on the right track. And then stay tuned for a wonderful special tribute to 9/11. Okay, standing here with me, Janet or Jeanette, which one do you prefer?
Janet.
Janet.
Yes, sir.
Okay, you're here to talk about obesity in our children.
Yes, sir.
Am I correct?
You are correct.
Tell us about the program at MUSC that can help families get on a healthy track.
Heart Health is the program at MUSC, and it is a very comprehensive program for children and teens that help them to establish healthy habits and healthy lifestyles.
Mm-hmm. What should parents be looking for and recognizing if there's a problem?
You know, actually, that's a good question, because our perspective is very off as far as seeing if children are obese or not, mm-hmm. or leading in that direction. And so it's really important for the parents to talk openly to their physicians about it. If they feel like there might be a situation happening where the child is gaining some extra weight that it's a little out of range of what it should mm-hmm. be, they definitely need to ask their physician, their pediatrician, to check their what's called BMI or body mass index to make sure that it's within the proper range, and then have that conversation with their doctors.
Is there a certain weight that a child should have at a certain age?
We base it on the BMI scale. So the body mass index is it's a range of a number that is based on their height and their weight, and it's also based on their age. So if they, you know, it's a scale, and so if they fall outside that range, you know, it's the 50th percentile mm-hmm. or the 80th percentile, the 90th percentile, of course we want to address it if it starts to get upwards of the 80th percentile and up.
Is this now a major problem with our children?
Absolutely, absolutely. We're getting close to having one third of our children and teens be overweight or obese in the country.
What are the schools doing to help assist in this?
The schools are actually starting to come around. We have our sister program called the Lean Team is actually working with the school system to change some of the policies and start incorporating some healthy lifestyle situations that can happen in the school setting as well. So they're coming around.
Mm-hmm. Now, should parents watch the diet
Absolutely.
At home?
Uh-huh. Absolutely. We talk about having a healthy food environment, mm-hmm. and that is in general just making sure there's not a lot of junk around, because if it's around, it'll get eaten. Mm-hmm. If the children want to have junk food, we're not saying they can't eat it ever. We're just saying that it shouldn't be in the home, because if they want it, they can go elsewhere and get it as a treat. If it's in the home, it'll become a regular occurrence. So definitely watching what's going on at home from a junk food standpoint and, you know, portion control, making sure they're getting enough fruits and vegetables, all those kinds of things.
Well, I do notice even some of my friends, when they want to get their children to do certain things, they'll promise them a special treat. Is that a good thing?
No, absolutely not. We always say that you should never use food as a reward. It just creates the wrong relationship with food. It kind of puts it on this pedestal that it shouldn't necessarily be on. It's always best to use some sort of little trinket or, you know, kids love money, things that are not food related to as a reward or an incentive for them to do things.
Mm-hmm. So how long has MUSC been working on this program?
Heart Health has been around we're going on our seventh year now. Mm-hmm. So we've been around for a while. We've been helping kids for a long time, and we have a lot of success, and we actually have a lot of families who are involved in the program and really enjoying it.
Mm-hmm. Is there a certain type of food listing that you send home with the children?
Sort of. I mean, we don't have, you know, forbidden foods at all, but we do give them what we call a stoplight food list, which categorizes foods according to how healthy they are based on mm-hmm. the green, yellow, red light kind of idea, mm-hmm. where green is healthy and then red is the unhealthy sort of things. And it just kind of gives them a guideline as far as how often they should be eating the not so healthy things.
Now, I've watched certain health food programs on TV, and they often say you should look at your plate, and if it's colorful, you're on the right track.
True. However, that's more so with fruits and vegetables, because there are a lot of colors of not so great food either, and some of them are like really weird colors that we probably shouldn't be eating, which are the more processed foods. But with fruits and vegetables, absolutely, the more colors you can get, the more nutrients you're going to get from the foods that you're eating.
Okay, so now that school has started, what should the cafeterias be looking out for?
You know, really, the cafeterias just need to be encouraging the children to have more fruits and vegetables, and they are starting to come around with having healthier options for the kids at the school lunches. There are still quite a few options that are not so great, and a lot of the bigger schools and high schools have a lot of fast food options that the kids can get on a regular basis. So that's a little tough, but they have to, you know, there's issues that the schools need to consider.
Okay, here's my problem. Being that this is an issue, then why is it that when we go to some of your fast food chains, you can do a bigger size?
A supersize.
Supersize, yes.
Because they want to make money, and that's how they make money. They don't care about our health. They care about the bottom line. And fortunately, again, a lot of the fast food chains are coming around and putting the calorie levels up on their menus and things like that, so that's helpful. But, you know, people are still going to pick what they want to pick, and mm-hmm. the fast food chains want to make money, so that's what it comes down to.
Are we monitoring the schools to see if they're following the healthy guidelines?
The programs that are set up right now, I do believe, have a monitoring system involved in place. So I don't know too much about that side of things because we're more in the clinic setting and they're in the school setting. The lean team is in the school setting, but I do believe they monitor the schools.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Are parents bringing their children in to see you all, that you all can counsel with them?
Yes. The Heart Health Program, we see the kids and their families in our clinic one-on-one every 2 weeks, and that's where we do the very personalized interaction with the kids, and we set goals with them. You know, we teach them healthy habits and really help them to get on a path to a healthy lifestyle.
Okay. Well, let's tell our viewing audience where they can find you all, what they need to do. Jeanette Carter, outpatient dietitian, Heart Health Program Manager, 843-792-4717. Or you can reach her at, what's that email address there?
It's Katjan, C-A-T-J-A-N, at musc.edu.
Okay, that's how we can find you. I think it's been wonderful talking with you today.
Nice to
on Bounce Around Charleston. And we will be watching what we eat and most of all what our children are eating.
Excellent, very good.
Coming up next, Life Management Center has helped more than 5,000 individuals, families, educators, and mental health professionals through their services and programs that help recognize the signs of learning problems. The executive director of the Life Management Center, Mary Beth Dacey, will be here to tell us more about it.